brothers and sisters. What's your name?
My name is Marion Rico Ramsey.
What's your name?
And I am Carmen Walker Mullen.
All right. And tell us why you're here today and what do you do as a group?
So, I'm here representing United Foundation Incorporated and One Nation of Power.
Okay, and we're here representing We the People, demand equal justice. We're also representing people that have been wrongfully incarcerated or have injustices through the penal system. And we're also here to give brotherly love and brotherly support to our neighboring counties. We're from Atlanta, and we have endeavors to go all over the state of Georgia to assist in and aid in community cleanup and whatever that's going to support the communities to come together.
Okay, how did you get down here to Valdosta? What brings you to Valdosta, Georgia?
Well, we did a cleanup in Cordell, Georgia in August, and we want to further that effort by coming to Valdosta. We have people in our group that are from Valdosta and they support this area. They love this is their home, and we want to give support and love and fellowship and coming to support the community.
Okay, thank you all very much. Where do you all plan to go? How long you plan to stay? I know you got here earlier this morning. How long you plan to be here in the city?
So the plan was originally that they would come down and we would do a cleanup from Hudson Docket, and we're going to end up at the Martin Luther King Memorial. And so when these guys reached out to me, you know, I was thrilled because they're actually trying to bring awareness to the criminal injustice that goes on here in America and the unfair penal system that we have, which is quite ludicrous towards people of color these days.
Short form, I know y'all got to get to work, but I would like for you to tell me, what do you know about the unfair penal system? What can you say about it? What experience? Who do you know that have been mistreated within that system?
Well, definitely for sure. These two right here from Cordell, Georgia. This is Carlton and this is Charles.
Okay.
They are definitely victims of that unfair and unjust penal system.
Okay, we're not here for that today, but short form, where can they find information about your cases? And how can ordinary folk help you or contribute to the cause of justice, maybe with a lawyer or what have you? If you got an email address, a website, you know, give it and you all can get to work. The Get To Free Press will be through for now. I'll walk with you all. Tell us something about your case.
Thank you, Mr. Boston. We the People demand equal justice here in Georgia. This campaign is also against, you know, the penal system, but our motive today is connecting and fellowshipping with most of the communities here in Georgia so that we could properly prepare ourselves within the community, within the election and votes that are coming up now. But we are here in Valdosta contributing to the things here in Valdosta as well. And Mr. Boston, we are definitely glad that you are here to cover the footage for us and also other social media sites that we're doing now. But we could be reached at email address charlesaverybrown@gmail.com. Also, you can find some of the court cases issued on my Facebook social media site, which is Wax Kid Brown, Cordell, Georgia, where you will see an online petition that is needed to be signed and issued in relationship to my court case.
Okay, you have something?
Yeah.
Okay, let me close out by saying this. First of all, the Get To Free Press, I'm on Boston GBR with almost 2 million views around the world, 2,400 subscribers, and I'm asking you all to tune into my channel. But above all, I'm going to walk with you all a while today, and again, let me extend my hand as a member of the social media. If TV stations, radio, and newspapers don't cover you all, what we have to do in America, across America, is stop relying on white people. We ain't got nothing against white folk, but we love us first, as they love them first. Japanese love them first. Koreans love them first. So we got to put up first instead of being in the back. We cannot elevate when we continue to depreciate one another. We must stand up for each other. And we must come and support. Although you all are not from Valdosta, but you see a need.
That's
again,
right.
I extend my hand to you. and say thank you for coming to Valdosta, because God knows we need all the help we can. And I hope to see y'all soon. Let's walk.
Let's walk. All right.
Let's do it. Y'all got some bad family.
Everybody got bad?
Daddy.
These are concerned citizens. They are not from Valdosta, but they go around the state to help clean up and pick up paper that they did not put down. But they know that black folk need to live in clean community just like white folk. And so they come to assist. Although we see each and every day people throwing beer bottles, Coke bottles, and what have you out of their vehicles, many of us will stop and pick it up, because we know that just because we are black don't mean that, how you doing, Joe? All right. Does not mean that we don't want things clean for our community and our children. Unless our children see us participating in our community and getting involved and picking up what others throw down. Here's some over here, y'all. They will always think that we are to be the laughing stock of the world. So I want to thank these people for coming all the way from Atlanta. Not only Atlanta, Cordell, and all in between. They come to clean up the black community. A lot of people don't appreciate it, but we must say, when black folks start helping black folk, our trouble will end. This is the Get To Free Press, and we report what others ignore. This is what they call the Hudson Docket area. We are close to the Mildred Hunter Center, and this is the Tree of Wisdom, they call, where people come and sit and eat, drink, and have conversation. Black folk often do not have a country club. So this is the country club for the black community right across the street, where people come and enjoy each other. No violence, no drugs, no fighting. They just do what they do. And we commend them for enjoying each other outside of violence. And this is the logo that they work under. And I think it's a beautiful logo. I just asked my brother, what's your name, brother?
Mike.
Thank you so much, man. Senior citizen,
yes.
She want to thank you all for what you're doing in the community.
Oh, man.
So I just thought I'd call you all over. Go ahead and tell them what you say now.
Yeah, this is a wonderful thing. Y'all just keep this up.
Oh, man.
And
thank
keep the others away from them, throw it on there. That's nice.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
Is my name.
Yes, ma'am. I would like to give you a hug. Thank you.
Yeah, I appreciate that. They might appreciate the
mother
guy, but I appreciate what y'all
are
doing.
Yeah. You're more than welcome, ma'am.
What's your name again?
Anna Mitchell.
Thank you so much for the comments.
Yeah.
Thank you. Somebody appreciate it. Thank you so much.
I certainly appreciate it.
Thank y'all, child.
Yeah.
Beg your pardon?
I can tell them over and over, but they won't listen.
Right.
But it's a wonderful job.
Thank you so much, man. Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is George Boston Rice. I'm going to come back. I promise you, I'm going to come back to talk to you.
Right.
I promise you that because I'm from Valdosta. You be from Atlanta and all around.
Oh.
Some of them from Valdosta, most of them from out of town.
Oh, well, that's so
I will come back and see you, Ms. Mitchell.
Okay.
Thank you.
In creation, there are signs that testify to the oneness of divine. That's the reason why we become aware of divine blessing as we
come. Beg your pardon? Thank you so much. What's your name? Thank you very much. Thank you.
I'm from Bay neighborhood over in Memphis. Okay. I've been living
on this field since I was a year old. I'm 70
years old now. I'll be 71
Wednesday where I live to see. Uh-huh. And I appreciate y'all doing this because it sure makes us
look bad. It really does. Thank you so much.
And I don't like it, but ain't
nothing I can do about it. Oh, that's so
beautiful. Thank you for
your comments, mother. Thank you. Thank you. Thank all of y'all. Yes. Okay.
Thank you.
That's what they've been saying, you see.
Wait till the next generation.
There you'll find your identity.
Wait till the next generation.
We're gonna be ready to take a stand.
Wait till the next generation.
And take control of the life that's in your hands. All along the road. Freedom and democracy. Gaining moral strength.
This group seemed very eager and energetic once they saw Martin Luther King drive this. We got to clean and pick up on Martin Luther King. I don't know how dirty it is, but they said they had to come down here in honor of the man. And I think that's a good, great goodwill gesture. And so I know Vivian and Cody, she has been out here and others. It's not like local people haven't done it, but these people came all the way from Atlanta and Cordell and many other areas to pick up what other people throw down and mess up.
They've been saying, you
wait
see.
Wait till the next generation.
There you'll find your identity.
Wait till the next generation.
We're gonna be ready to take a stand.
Wait till the next generation.
And take control of the life that's in your hands. All along the road. Freedom and democracy. Gaining moral strength. Wisdom and stability. There's gonna be a victory for the common man. A vast awakening all across the land. All across the land. But it's gonna be hard to find. We're gonna select the things that go into our mind. Shape our own destiny.
Wait till the next generation.
And alter the face of history. democracy, gaining moral strength, wisdom, and stability. It's gonna be a victory for the common man, a vast awakening all across the land, all across the land
of the next generation.
This I want you to understand.
That's candidate Bussey. He's running for mayor of the city of Valdosta, Georgia. He's greeting the cleanup crew here.
We're gonna take it. We gotta get everybody up there. All right, the ground take.
Okay.
I was just telling them about how I was. Yeah, we got to start holding people accountable, not just the personnel that mess up, but the personnel that mess up behind the scenes.
Right.
So whether or not it be the judge, whether or not it be the court-appointed individuals, we got to hold accountable every single person that does a great job. That's how we fix funding. It's not fair that we see too many unjust acts in the city of Valdosta, in the city of Fort Hill. The mayor is one of my good friends over there. When I tell you that there's a lot of unjust acts, and we've got to start highlighting on it, we got to put their strength in numbers.
Yeah.
Right. That is where you start to really make a stamp on the crime, is by getting the numbers, getting people behind you, and that's how we can really fix a lot of the issues in the city. Not only just about us, but in Cordell as well.
Absolutely.
You just got to get the people behind you, but the problem is that we're so separated. But if we just unify, there's so much strength in our power when we unify. So that's what we got to do. So I would love to see that kind of, fine, okay, that's fine. I got that part of it, but putting you in jail for so long just because of that one incident, I think that needs to be changed. So there's a lot of things, and everything is not going to happen overnight, but I think you got to make a stand and start somewhere.
Yes. And so these guys have been with me. He's been with me almost 6 months, but these guys have been with me for a total of at least 3 months. And consistent.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And they always show up to the events that we throw, and they love to give back to the community. When we get together, we talk about, life as a young black man in America.
Yeah.
We try to make sure that they're mentored correctly. And these guys are some special guys, man. I love these guys because they always, show love back to us and stuff like that. So,
what y'all don't know is that y'all are changing the course and the narrative and the culture of this city. Starting right now with what you guys are doing, you're already changing it. Most of the inspiration behind Valdosta is that you got to be a wildcat, right? Most of y'all want to play football. But you can be a whole lot more than that. A whole lot more than that, too. You're so intrigued. You haven't taken your eyes off me. So that lets me know that it's something that you want to do that's going to be a whole lot bigger than football. Doctors, lawyers, prisoners, governors, anything that you guys want to be. But that's where it starts right here. And I'm proud of y'all, man. I really am. And y'all continue doing what you're doing. Don't stop. Don't be discouraged and don't be deterred by other individuals. Because somebody going to look at you and say, man, what you doing out here with these guys? Yeah. And you're going to be like, man, all right, I'm going to go on this side. No, you stay right where you are. These guys are mentoring and putting something in your chest and your heart and your mind, body, and soul. And you're going to be great just because of that. Yeah. Yeah. Y'all keep doing it.
Mr. Buzzy, before you leave, we definitely would like to ask again. We will be leaving Vidalsa heading to Dublin, Georgia. Okay. Then after that, we'll be leaving to Fitzgerald. And those counties, could you please turn around? Those counties on the back, that is the circuit for Cordelia, Georgia. Okay. And those counties is being battered and bruised by the legal system. So that's why we started this campaign for going on 15 months now. Okay. And we definitely would like for you to attend the next gathering within Dublin, Georgia. Well, we haven't placed it on the map yet, but we do have other brothers here from Atlanta.
Okay, okay.
Okay, these are some of the guys that came from Atlanta. I come from Atlanta, but I stay in Cordelia as well. So hopefully in Dublin, we'll have other counties that come in. I'm thinking like Macon, Savannah, Ronald Robbins, and Augusta.
Yeah.
They want to come on the next term in Dublin. Yeah. So we would like for you to...
You're going to have my personal contact. You're going to have my email. You got my personal contact information. Hit me up.
Yeah.
Let me know what the next event is going to be. I promise you one thing, and I'm a big man on promises. I'll be right there with you every step of the way. Not walking behind you, but walking alongside you.
Thank you.
I'll be there.
Thank you. Yes,
sir. And I appreciate you guys. Thank y'all.
Yeah, no doubt.
Hey, can we get a group here?
Romans 8:7 says, because the carnal mind is enmity against God,
in a hurry.
For it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be.
But
God be the glory.
All right,
man.
Thank y'all
for coming by, man. Oh, yeah.
Good
things, man. Yeah, Lord, man. Yeah, yeah, we are fighting down here, man.
Tell the name of your
organization,
real quick.
Yeah, yeah, well, people are the man. You can just be out there. Now, we're also in charge of what we need. We're also
around
as well. Okay. Try hard to be like you.
Busy man. I'm going to thank God to give us a little time that he had. And by the way, look at that picture on that truck there. That says everything in Valdosta, Lawrence County. I mean, he's an entrepreneur. He's a businessman. He is really a detriment to this community in terms of positive asset. Okay? Y'all have a nice day, Valdosta County.
Question I want to ask is, do you get
the mayor's spot, what was your intention in towards the prison reform?
Well, everybody makes mistakes. Everybody's perfect. So, what's a person that's paid to quote unquote debt to society, they should have every opportunity as anybody else. So, I give you an example. I retired from the fire department.
Yeah.
35 years as a firefighter. The last 18 of those was fire chief.
Okay.
We petitioned the state back in the early 90s to allow single-star building, a lot of institutions. There was not enough firefighters to cover all of them.
Yeah.
So we petitioned the state to train some of those inmates as firefighters. And not only that, it went a step further. Those who weren't trained as firefighters got their certification, so when they need to release, they can get informed of the fire department.
Yeah.
So I believe in it. I know it works.
Yeah.
So I can give you a testimony on that, for sure.
Yeah. But those are some of the angles that you would like to attack. Yes. The prison reform act?
Yes, no doubt, no doubt.
Right.
And I think it's a disservice for anybody to even have a box on their application that you got to check whether you've been a fellow or whatever. That shouldn't even be on there.
So that box is on the application here in Bylaw?
No, it's taken off of City Hall.
Right, right.
But there's still employers that still have it on their box.
Right.
But it shouldn't be taken off. It shouldn't be on there.
Right, right. So that's what most of the people here in the community is stressing the point about the box being checked?
Well, I've heard that.
Okay, right.
It's been a while since I filled out a job application, but
right.
I know at the city they took it off there. But to me, it's discriminatory, even if it is on there.
Right. So
that's like asking a person, does he have a physical disability?
Right.
You know, that's infringing on their right to privacy.
Right.
So, once a person does what they're supposed to do by being in the society, he should have every opportunity.
Basically, the question that we teach you how to ask.
So, right off one program,
I think the other has a great time to attend, if I also do another community cleanup, we would like to offer extend our service to you to attend with us.
That'd be great. I'd love to, man.
And Dublin and Georgia.
Yeah.
Well, can I have your card?
I don't have any card on. I just
Right.
But I would love to do it. The double A, but I'll have
yes. Okay, good. Mr. Wright, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Mr. Boston Ryan right here is a good friend of mine. I definitely carry him on my back.
Well, I appreciate it. I think what y'all doing is wonderful, man.
Yeah, right. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much.
All right.
Please continue.
Thank you. Y'all enjoy.
Big Knicks play. Big Knicks, Valdosta, Georgia. If you ever come to Valdosta, don't miss Big Knicks play. Bay Tree. Yes, sir. Good food, good people.
In their desire.
Struggle with trying to bring about order, peace, and tranquility, and the law of seeds. He sent messages and prophets to man so that he may receive the blueprint for human growth and development. Now, these prophets had to scribe and scribe to carry on the revelation of the Almighty.
Y'all have some better faith.
Standing in a rainstorm, I believe. Hater, 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 I believe. Hit 'em up.
send me home on my way. Raise my voice for justice.